DC, and this is a matchup I'm really looking forward to. I think if you look over the course of the entire tournament, the team that's been the best at adapting and like finding solutions for problems in the draft has been EG, who seem to, in this game as well, have forced, I don't want to say they forced CDEC out of their comfort zone, because this is five heroes that CDEC play very well. But it's not the type of lineup we've seen from them in their previous 2-0 sweeps, for example, against LGD. They're going to fall back on their classic Tusk Undying opener for this game. And in addition to that, EG, of course, forcing them to ban the techies, which really influences the entirety of the draft because CDC don't get that key first phase ban that they would have liked for something else.
Yeah, and it's totally understandable, of course, CDC. I was talking to some of the analysts earlier saying that they are one of the teams that just really struggles against the techies. They just haven't seemed to have found the way to deal with it, and you know, understandably so. Let's not play with it. Let's look for something else. And CDC here, the early movement into the Radiant Jungle, just trying to get some wards down. At the same time, EG to be grouped up towards this top room, ready to contest, but CDC looks like they'll just secure themselves the bottom. I mean, from a draft perspective, do you feel that anyone's coming into this with a stronger lineup, or do you feel it's pretty balanced between the two sides? Has PPD found the edge this time?
I think EG's lineup is stronger if they don't lose the laning phase. It's the big question mark here is how much they can get out of Q's Visage, which I was thinking CDC might go for that pick in this game and just run a really strong laning phase and try to pressure EG so much that they don't get to come online with their, like, I want to say it's a classic like slow play kind of game from EG again. The support duo Dazzle Naga is pretty defensive, and then they have a tanky Razor Core and a Shadow Fiend who's probably going to build mech and get tanky too. And they're going to just try to wait for the mid game when their lineup peaks, where CDEC can force the issue really early. And maybe they can look to take towers before Naga gets level 6. That's a really key point for EG, as was also brought up by Matt on the panel.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing how well CDEC can try and crush the lanes with that Tusk Undying combination. I mean, it's a hero combo that we don't see a lot of teams get through, and normally one or the other being banned when one has been picked up in the draft. And already trying to go in onto Aoi here. Fear with the Static Link, moving in onto Xe, stealing quite a bit here as well. Going in onto Garda, but Garda with those double decay stacks is going to be okay. So, I mean, yeah, Tusk Undying, are they going to be able to do a lot to hinder Fear's farm here, do you feel?
I don't really think so. The way they can possibly do it is if they get enough decays out with Garda right now and they surprise him with pumping level 2 on XC and then immediately go for a snowball, then maybe. But this dual lane of EG is tailored to survive. It's just very tanky, both Razor and Naga are pretty difficult to bring down the lane to top lane, though. They're putting a lot of pressure on aggressive here with the poison touch.
Whoa, indeed. He's got to be very careful as well. I like what Universe had. He's got this early point here in the Caustic Finale, making it that little bit harder for Aggressive to farm on that Ember Spirit in the safe lane.
If he goes for a CS now on this wave, he's dead, actually. He's going to get stunned and Shadow Wave. So, has to be careful here. And he is playing it correctly. Just waiting out. He'll try to get whatever CS he can under his tower. And so far, so good for the EG dual lane off lane. I think they've got the late matchups they wanted. They wanted the Ember to be top and face that there. They're pretty comfortable with putting Samael one-on-one against a TA with Shadow Fiend. He is very well-versed in this particular matchup, SSF, and you can see he's winning the lane.
Yeah,
right now.
After that wave, he's starting to create the edge here. 11 for 4 against 7 for 1 on Shiki's TA. So yeah, Samael's going to be happy with how this one started up. Top lane PPD, just doing what he can for the low ground as CDC pull the wave towards the side. Aggressive, his farm 7 for 1, 6 for 3 on Fear, so pretty even between the two positions. Ones.
Has been killed.
And the courier is down. Aoi there with the haste rune, able to snipe it. Didn't have anything on, but nonetheless, nice little bit of play there with the haste from Aoi.
Yeah, you're just not going to expect that. If there was a bounty hunter on EG, you're playing safe with your courier, but what are the odds, right? He got the exact rune he needed to go for that courier snipe at that point in time. And this is a big advantage for EG. First of all, they're already doing well in mid, but now Samael can actually flat out outlane the TA, not just on farm, but actually force her back. She will need to follow Crown. You can see he's taking full advantage of his position right now, just really going in aggressively, removing the entirety of Refraction. Here come the raises. All right, that's another Refraction. But now Shiki's going to be out of mana.
This lane is becoming harder and harder for the TA. In fact, Shiki's got to be careful here, getting low. The raise bringing him right down, and that's probably, yeah, he's going to have to go back to base here. So, more of an edge here to Samael, who's really breaking away. 18 for 8, back to base for Shiki. This early game looking very good for the side of EG as well. Universe, I mean, he's 15 for 1 here on this SK. He's out CSing the Ember Spirit. Across the board, I don't think it could be going any better here for EG in these first few minutes.
And the aggressive dueling from CDC, we've seen this in the past. This has been something, especially in the qualifiers in the Chinese region, they love picking their
turns. Oh, PBD! 14 HP there, Universe getting chased down here by aggressive. He's going to be fine, healed up by the Dazzle. Here we go with the first strike onto aggressive. He needs to be careful of Q, of course, with that Soul Suction, and then he's going to turn around and find the kill. First blood there to Q. Very nicely taking advantage of the fact that Universe went a little bit too aggressive there.
Yeah, PVD still had cooldown on Shadow Wave, I think. It was just getting ready. They would have needed it to try for the kill. And even if he got it off, they might still not have found the kill. I think aggressive baited him a bit there. I believe he did have some stick charges to pull advantage off him. This is very important for CDC, who are, to be fair, getting really destroyed in the laning phase. It's not an absolute beatdown, but they're definitely falling behind here. Their aggressive dual lane Tuscan dying that we saw a lot from them in the Chinese qualifiers then started getting
He's got to be
out.
Careful. Look at this now. How he's come up on the Naga. There's no crew wave. They could dive this one here. Moving in onto the Ember Spirit. Aggressive. He's got nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Universe of PBD coming in for the kill. They'll find it. Bringing it to 1-1 on the board. EG equalizing the kills.
They're also going to steal a little bit of a stack here with Universe. Or not a stack, but rather just the single pull. He's got 1 point in Caustic Finale. I'm curious to see if he's going to put any more points in it, or if he just gets it for the value slow right now and is going to max out Sandstorm. Because it is possible that they can play this lane very aggressively. The combination they have with heroes is, let's say Ember is going for a CS in the creep wave. You Burrow Strike in with Caustic Finale on one or two melee creeps, and then you Shadow Wave the Sand King and the wave, and you can deal so much damage.
Look at this mid lane. Sumail is just bullying Sheiky right back. I mean, you look at the CS and still the top three all on the side of EG. Universe is up there second on the Sand King. I mean, I can't remember the time I've seen a laning stage go this favorable to one side. This is quite the start here for EG. And Fear, of course, getting a lot of space in this spot. It just feels like this Tuscan Undying haven't really been able to do that much to stop the Razor's fight.
Why they stay down there? They could try to rotate the Tusk to the top lane and win that lane, for example, or try to get Sheiky a gank in the mid lane, so they seem a little bit stubborn on playing this as a dual lane. And of course, the idea of the draft is that these two heroes synergize so well. You have Frozen Sigil together with the Tombstone, Snowball, and Ice Shards to block off their exit path so more zombies spawn. It is, in theory, a really powerful lane, but when you look at what they're up against, it's just extremely unlikely for them to find a kill on either of these heroes. And to be frank, they're kind of wasting their time a bit down here.
We'll see if they decide to make any movements yet. 6.5 minutes into the game. Some mail as well. Have any stacks been created yet in the jungle? It doesn't look like we've got one. The double stack down here, okay.
He's probably going to triple that with PVD and then some mail's going to farm it. He's going to get a very, very early mech at this rate. 43 CS minutes 7 in the mid lane.
I mean, what is the plan here? This is going to be the plan. They're going to smoke up with Sheiky on the bottom lane. He's got level 6, got those traps here, so maybe you have to chase down Fear. They're going to go in for the snowball. Here we go. CDC looking for a kill onto Fear. It'll be a big one if they can find it. Ali there coming in to try and have Haber. Fear's already dead. Ali going to look for the TP out. They haven't got anything to cancel it. And that was, CDC needed that. And that was a big kill as well. Oh, mid lane though. Sumail gets himself a solo kill in return onto Q. But all in all, the fact that CDC did manage to find the kill onto Fear.
Yeah, and if this was the alternative, either you rotate to TA's lane and gank the Shadow Fiend, or you rotate the TA to the bottom lane and kill the Razor. And I think they just decided the bottom lane is one rotation less. They end up being three heroes by running her down there. And in addition, the Shadow Fiend had a haste, so that would have been an almost impossible kill to get. So they do find a kill on Fear. But I think EG aren't going to be too fazed by it. They know that Sumail is absolutely rolling in this game.
He's a mile ahead of the tier now. 51 for 14 against the 25 for 3. The fact that he's got those kills under his belt as well.
He gave the stacks to Sand King, by the way.
Okay. I mean, he's going to have a very quick timing on his Blink Dagger. He's nearly at 1700 gold. And with this, we're going to see a pre-10 minute Blink easily here for Universe.
Yeah. That's scary, because you want to have that ready when Song is up, and, well, you definitely do. In addition to that, you can probably find some ganks in, especially, I would say, the bottom lane is going to be a very easy target for Universe and the Sand King. The mid lane can still be a little tricky if TA has her refraction stacks up. That's certainly possible.
1900 gold on Universe. This is, yeah, he's going to be able to do so much with his Blink, and I really like how the Sand King picks worked out. It was able to make it very hard for the Ember Spirit to farm in lane against him. And now, of course, getting that early Blink is going to mean that EG can amp up the pressure. CDC, though, they want to do that themselves again. A smoke on bottom. They're looking for that Bear kill. But yeah, I think he's going to play a little bit more safely this time, backing up towards the tier one. Realizes the CDC are off the map, and is he going to come out here with a creep wave? But CDC actually turning their attentions away. Now the ping's coming back out. Bear realizes, though, as the trap gets dropped, that there's people in the neighborhood, and he's going to play it safe, backing behind the tower, and he's going to be able to avoid this gank.
They might still try to go for a dive. I think that's going to be super risky here, but EG might not expect it because of how unlikely it is. Perhaps CDC will decide. They do have the good vision with the ward they just placed down behind, so they should know there's no support here.
Okay. There's a lot of time they're spending, though, trying to zone attack. Out Fear. I mean, they're shutting down his farm, but the space that's been given to Samael in the mid lane, you know, he's now confident enough to just walk into the enemy jungle and take what he can from their own camps. And he'll continue to farm, and then reach out to level 10. He's at 5,200 net worth. He is 2,000 ahead of the position one of CDEC aggressive Zembla. This is, before 10 minutes in, this is Sumail getting entirely out of control.
And they have to address that problem, I think. This is not, the CDEC draft doesn't deal particularly well with a Shadow Fiend, in my opinion. The one who does counter him pretty well is the one who's been destroyed in the
he's got his Blink. Blinks himself away there from Exe. God, Ashiki's there as well, spotting out Samael. But backup is there available for EG. Aggressive's going to go in with the Remnants here. But Samael here with the Orbs. He'll pin by the Flame Guard. Now Samael's in trouble. The Snowball's closing in. We'll catch him with the Sun. They are going to fight. Samael is still alive. We'll now go down. That's going to be the first chance. See Universe getting away. CDC moving in. He's trying to hit him back. We'll find the kill onto Garda. Now they turn their attention to Fear, but Fear's just a little bit too tactical. The Weave Armor ticking up. Oh, Universe gets the kill there onto Dust. Fear's still alive. He's looking for Q. He's going to get it. And BPD will finally go down. So it's a 2-for-3 favoring the side of EG. Aggressive and Shiki now on the retreat, but Veer's able to live throughout that all and get himself involved in a lot of those kills. It does slightly favor the side of CDAC because of the fact that they did get that kill onto Samael, who was quite far ahead in comparison to how CDAC's heroes were doing so far 10 minutes in.
It's a really good sign for EG when they're able to 3-2 a fight that they play 4 and 5. Like, Naga wasn't even there. Aoi was top, he's getting level 6.
Dire's middle
he
tower
split pushed a bit
attack.
Of the tower. He forces a rotation from XC defensively here, and now he's just going to back out as he realizes, okay, the heroes are respawning. I could be the target. Plays it safe. They'll have Song next time, and then they can probably take an even more convincing fight just dealing with the Tombstone and playing from there.
At this point, Aoi's going to be feeling more confident to just push out the lanes and farm up and start to rise himself up through that net worth. As you can already see, there's top three still on the side of EG. CDC yet to be able to catch up. TA trying to catch up with his Universe Sanky, but Sanky on 4,200 net worth. Looking very good. CDC teeping into the mid lane for the defense, but EG just backing themselves off. Shadow Fiend, so he's going to be looking for that Yules here as his first item. Universe and PPD smoked up, moving towards the top lane. So they're able to find anything here. XZ's just on his own. He has found level 7 here on the Tusk. Bottom lane, the Familiar's trying to scout out Fear. It is just aggressive in the neighborhood, though. So he won't be able to take down Fear on his own. He's going to need some backup, and backup is on its way. CDC moving Shiki down towards this bottom lane, along with Q. They've also got Garda coming in as well, so they're sending 4 heroes down for this one. PPD is there, ready to back up, and Fizz just gonna, he's gonna have backup coming in because the TP in from Aoi. Aoi, Dyer's with the Song of the Siren available. Maybe EG can try and look for a Dyer's fight. It's gonna be a TP out straight away from Q. He does not want to fight in this one. He is now gone.
That's a pretty big mistake from Q. Very unusual for him as well. Just park the familiars and just let EG take the both of them. As I understood in the start, I thought it was on purpose because it looked like he kept them there to have the creep wave just hit them instead of scouting out their positions as they might have been spotted by the creeps. But instead, it looked like he just forgot about them and was just too familiar with ultimate on cooldown as well. CDC decide they cannot fight that.
So bottom lane, we are seeing Zone here aggressive. Going in on Sophia, but this backup, yeah, he's just going to Remnant straight out. Doesn't want to hang around here in this lane. He's still got a fair bit of catching up to do now. He's now managed to reach up to the same level as Universe and Sand King, but it is still Fear and Samael that are very much in the lead in terms of farm. And that's your Yule's now done here on the Shadow Fiend, so Sumail's got this killing potential. If he finds any hero on the map now at this point, he should be able to blow them up.
This item allows him to solo TA. Even if she has max refractions on, he can just duel her, go in and blow the ultimate, and it should probably be enough to, even through refraction, almost one shot her at this point with her 900 health.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Definitely looking to play aggressively. There's another side benefit of this item, of course. It's able to dispel Flame Guard, which is purgeable.
Radiant's bottom tower.
I can't remember if it was 683 or 684, but it's very, very good item against the Emperor Spirit, who at this stage in the game is super reliant on the Flame Guard. It's technically Yuling the Emperor Spirit deals 550 magic damage to him when he has Flame Guard on. So, it's pretty sick.
Oh, he's going to move in onto Aoi, though. He's caught him out, but the Song of the Siren will be there. Aoi will be able to back himself up, and he's just going to look for the straight TP out here, avoiding the game going to the side of CDC.
Nice play from Aggressive, though. I think he actually couldn't even have killed AUI there, but he got really scared because of the triple Remnant. It looks like such a super confident Aggressive play that he thinks there's backup. He does get the Song TP, which is what he wanted. I think this is the exact plan Aggressive had in mind. Just playing the mental game there.
So down for now to 3 minutes. Up to 15 minutes in. We did see Drums now being completed by Fear. And Universe now with the Tranquils and Sol Ring on top of the Blink Dagger. I mean, what is the next point of call here for EG? Are they looking to go aggressive themselves, or are they happy kind of waiting until CDEC try and look for another fight?
I think they should wait for their mech. I'm a little bit surprised that neither Fear nor Samael went for a mech first item. I thought when I saw the Yules on Samael, I look over to Fear and I'm like, okay, he's definitely building a mech. Nope, he went for a drum. So they might just slow down a little bit until they have that. I'm imagining they want to get it on one of them still. It's such a good item against the battle lineup. The AoE armor is great. The heal is going to counter out the Ember Spirit's spread damage very nicely. It's kind of a must-buy, I think, in this game. CDC. Maybe they put it on Sand King.
We're going to go for a smoke here. Let's see where they head towards. He's coming out. We've already seen EG back up behind the tier 1 on this top lane, so they're not going to be able to catch anyone out here. And it looks like, again, CDC, they've been looking for stuff across the map. Won't be able to... Oh, unless Aoi comes out here. He still hasn't got the song for 80 seconds. If he comes out too close and aggressively catches him, he's going to change. Now the snowball coming in. Easy pick off there for the side of CDC is how he just overstepping the mark a little bit on that lane.
This is probably a tower as well. This is the big benefit of smoking like this. It's been talked about previously as well. Even if you don't find anyone, you're suddenly 5 heroes in one place and you get a tower. But EG are ready for the counter.
Oh, the Yule's on to the Undying, moving in with the burst track as well. Garda gonna get taken down there by EG. And as you said, CDC will be able to find the space for this top tier 1.
Radiant's
cheeky with the double damage.
EG got the better tower though. They got the mid tier 1 of
kill.
The Dire and the kill.
So,
considering Adi actually being the smoke, yeah, they steal this too. This is
Radiant's
really big.
Top tower is under attack.
Now, CDC should know this with their Hydron ward, but I don't know if they can do anything about it. They're simply not in position to contest this. It's a male. As well as Fear will be getting even more damage now. Samael already with the Yasha.
Yasha Yules, this man's going to be incredibly speedy, moving towards the mid lane. He has this Invis rune, has the Rec Room as well, if he can line it up. He's got the refraction out though. If he gets some kind of back of this, Samael could certainly go for this. And the blink away there just in time from TA, as the Burst Strike did come in from Universe.
They're going to kill the birds. He has a resummon, so I think he's going to... Oh, maybe they're scared of a counterplay here, as they should be.
CDC moving in, Samael. Still with a good duration of his Invis. Ready to go, and he's going to use the Yules here on 10, but doesn't look like he's going to follow it through.
Bye bye, Flame Guard. How annoying that this to play against. Like, Emperor is one of my favorite heroes to play right now. Whenever the enemy gets a Yules, I'm just like, oh.
That change did hurt the hero a lot.
That is. But he's still a really high pick in this tournament, even with heroes such as Lina being popular with the Yules pickup, and of course the situational one from Shadow Fiend. But it is frustrating losing your Flame Guard for absolutely nothing.
To the jungle, CDC. Garda coming in, heading towards the bottom. Aggressive's managed to find a little bit more farm now on the Ember Spirit. He's catching up. He's now fourth on the board, so just 1,000 behind Fear. He's actually kind of catching up here with Samael. Trying to play off these. Samael now with the Yasha, what's he go for now as his next item? Does he just finish off the full S1?
I think so.
Yeah.
Seems like a reasonable choice. He can't go for a Manta if he wants to have a way of breaking out of Searing Chains. It's pretty decent, but at the same time, he should have BKB somewhere on his list. SNY is just the stronger snowballing build with his early lead. Keep up the farming phase. Look to be a little bit more tanky in the fights as well. He's just, you can tell he's just feeling in control, right? He just farms the enemy jungle with no vision. He's not scared of anything right now. And of course, in part, it is because they see a couple of heroes on the map with their own observer wards. It feels like the remaining two or three cannot take it out.
Found the PPD, but he needs to be careful. GR around the corner. He's just trying to work towards that Desolator. Hasn't really enough money here for the second Mithril Hammer. Now Samael coming into his own jungle. Sheiky's going to back off, and the ping is coming out as well. Aggressor's got to be careful here as well. Trying to work his way towards that battle fury now on top of the drums. And always going in. They want to try and fight, but EG's all there. They want to focus on the aggressive. There's the Requiem. We'll remove the flame guard. Now they're going to continue to chase down Sheiky. Aggressive looks for the Searing Chains. Is he going to find it? Sheiky's going to go down. Samael moving forward, maybe trying to find more, but aggressive there with the remnant. We'll be able to escape. But nonetheless, wanting to get onto the TA, and CDC just getting a little bit ahead of themselves. They're trying to fight into EG's lineup. Didn't quite realize that they were all around the corner, ready and waiting.
This is the strength for Samael right now. If he can Yule off the Flame Guard, it takes them really long to kill him off. And it's very easy for EG to get in reinforcements. At that point in time, they had them completely red. Same thing was already active before. But even if he was, they might have been able to TP on the tier 2 and actually save him.
Bill as well. If you look at Fear, he's nearly got the Aghanim Scepter complete. Once he's got that on the Razor, EG are going to be very much ready to start to push, and it's going to be so hard for CDC to defend as well. I mean, anytime they come close to the tower, we can expect to see Aoi come out with the song, and then EG will just find themselves in position for a big weave, big epicenter, big Requiem of Souls. It's going to get harder and harder for CDC.
It looks like Aoi will be carrying them back for EG here. He's gonna go for Guardian Greaves. On the other side for CDC. They have the mech on Q. It's kind of unusual these days to buy mech on the Visage. We used to see the Solar Crest and Aghanim Scepter, or most of the time actually only Solar Crest. I feel like it's been a while since we've seen an Axe, just because it's pretty expensive to go for that build-up, and most teams favor the Crest. But this could be the game where Q finds that farm. At the rate this is going, this could be a very long game. And CDEC at this point have to realize they're probably going to have to play more defensively and play for the late game with high ground defense. Of course, Visage is really good for it with the birds, ice shards. TA can get pretty strong. Ember Spirit has won quite a few games on his high ground this tournament, so might play for the 70-80 minute territory with their lineup now. I think that's what they have to do, more or less. They can look for pickoffs, but realistically, winning a team fight now in CDG's lineup is very, very difficult.
Does dispel the smoke. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Potentially, Aoi. Still under the cover of it. She's going to jump in and then pound PPD here with the Searing Chains. Amelius as well will be able to get the D ward there onto the sentry. But again, EG very much really in a position of control. Desolator's now complete here onto your TA. We'll see what she's able to do with that on top of the next fight. They're actually going to smoke up themselves, CDC. If they can find a wraparound, catch out the side of EG.
Dire's middle tower
might just find Samael here. He's going to bottle himself up this room. He's going to look for Roshan, okay? And I kind of like this here, because they're going to do it fairly quickly. Okay, EG, I think they're aware there. Lucian's going to scout it out. And the weave dropped as well. Now Universe trying to find a Roshan. We'll find out Garda here. Dead's trying to kick this one off. Universe forcing himself away. Now there's the song. The shards have actually stopped EG from being able to find themselves in a position to fight. So it looks like they're just going to back themselves away from the tombstone. Aggressive wants to fight now. Going straight in. Yours is going to be there. Sheiky goes for looking for Aoi. Aoi, the shadow crater is there just in time for PBD. Universe has jumped to the middle of it, although, and they'll lose the sand king. PBD's actually trapped up here, but the ice shards stop. So he comes into bed. With the red grip, gets it off. Now Fear is going to be able to turn this one. The ice snowball coming out straight for Samael. Fear being healed up by PBD from the back line. Fear getting low, but he's got the Shadow Break. He's trying to find something, but I don't know if he'll find anything here. And I think he'll pay off his life. He's looking for Q, but the Soul Assumption from Q coming out beautifully. Now Aoi as well, the Searing Chains from Aggressive. And what a fight for CDEC. They may even find more. They're chasing down PPD here. PPD's on the run. Will he be able to get himself out of this? No, the Soul is closing it up for him. He's got a Shadow Break. Not even out. Yes, he gets it off. Gonna look for the TP. Can he get himself out of the Snow Banner here? No, the stun from the Familiars. He's down. CDEC take four of EG and And now they'll be able to look back to Roshan.
Just ran his Manta or some... What was that? He had an illusion chasing Q all the way to base and killing him there. That must have been an illusion rune. He died up here. He got killed by an Illu.
Wow. Samael trying to equal off the bomb, but nonetheless, CDC very much coming out top. 4-2.
So what's
they
really,
get Roshan and the Aegis.
What's really important in that fight is that the Ice Shards from XC are incredible. He splits the fight in two. He blocks the entire path for EG after the song has already been used. So they have kind of no counterplay there. And CDC just isolate one target after the other. And when you look at how EG initiated that, so Universe goes in for the blink burrow, tries to find two targets. TA immediately blinks out so he doesn't find her. And then he's in an awkward position where he has to disengage and they have to use the song, and they don't manage to find the combination of song into epicenter as a result, which is the only thing EG really needs to win a team fight. If CDC are somewhat clustered up, you song, you MP, you blink, and you burrow two or three heroes, the fight is just lost, which is why I said I don't think CDC should be fighting. Under those conditions, their lineup is still really dangerous.
Very, very good point. I'll come back to that now. Aggressive has got his completed battle here. He should be able to step up the farm. Still 24 minutes in, 9-9 on both sides. It's been quite a passive game. A little bit of a slower pace, but as you said, EG. They'll be calm. I mean, do you think both teams are going to be happy taking this one late, or is there a clear advantage here for one of the lineups?
I think it's difficult to say. If it goes like really, really late, I think EG might have to farm Aoi and turn him into a core Naga. Because Razor and Shadow Fiend aren't really the fiercest of super late gamers in comparison to, in my opinion, a TA and Ember. And then you look at the supporting cast, Visage scales really well late game. The Tusk, Frozen Sigil is always going to be a problem. It's hard to say, really. I think it's slightly favoring CDC.
Well, this is a very nice kind of, it feels like a recovery from a very bad kind of farming stage. And I'll find this kill on PBD as well. XC going forward with the blink of the pop. PBD with the Shaman Grave here. I don't know if he's going to be able to keep himself alive and pop the charges, but Aggressive's still there, looking for him with a slide of fist. We'll find the kill. Now he's going to make it look more. The Yules will hold him back, but Shiki moving forward. The song coming out from Aoi. Looks like it'll be a defensive one as they just simply TP themselves out here and they will get themselves away. But CDC again, they find the kill and they'll almost certainly find this tier one here. This is looking very good for them in terms of farm. You've got the TA and the Ember now overtaking Fear's farm here on the Razor. It is still Samael that's 4,000 ahead, but if it keeps on like this, CDC should be able to close even that gap.
Wondering if Samael is making the right call right now. Looks like he's going to butterfly, so still no BKB. And there are quite a few things on CDC that can mess with him. This Bird stuns, Snowball. Of course, the Searing Chains an issue as well. And all the burst damage between something like Soul Rip and, of course, the Flesh Golem Amplification could be a problem. He's farmed, that's for sure. But he doesn't feel confident engaging into the CDC lineup, and he can't guarantee getting a Requiem off, which is a really big problem. See, EG are going to need that, not just for the burst damage, but also for the damage reduction against heroes like TA and Ember.
And this point is backing off there with the Axe, 1100 gold on top of it as well. And as you were saying, Samael, very close to finishing off that first.
Game's back to even, by the way. They pull back the entire lead EG had has gone down the drain.
Back to zero, very nice. As I said, the fact that CDC could have done that after such a bad early stage, this is impressive stuff here from the side. Again, if they want to keep control of this one. So I think CDC will be very happy with how they've brought this one back around 27 minutes in. And EG looks like they're going to group up and look for some towers themselves, try and get themselves this tier one from the squad away. And we'll see if any kind of defense comes out from the side of CDC, but it looks like the TPs are going to come out. So with the Battle Fury as well, Sleight of Fist, Aggressive going to be able to hold it for the time being. And EG, they're going to back up. They're actually going to TP elsewhere, look to continue to farm up on Fear as he heads towards the top. And now with the TP reaction, the wraparound towards Radiant's the mid lane as well. Looks like EG are thinking about fighting here. And Samaeli moves in and then he's going to get chased down here by the Familiars. So I'll look to scout him out.
He has the full butterfly on the courier. So Radiant no buyback, but he is really strong if he gets to fight on his terms right now. Like, ridiculously strong.
Very nicely done there. More gold is the pocket here at Shiki. 12,000 gold now onto your TA. 4,000 gold to spend as well. I mean, what does TA go now? Does he see the butterfly and just go straight for an MKB, or does he need to go for that Black King bar here in this situation?
It depends what his goal is in the fights. If he thinks he needs to hard counter the Shadow Beam, of course MKB is great.
Aggressive catching up there, moving in very aggressively as well. We'll run them back. They'll find themselves in the potential universe for the most part. Tashin keeping the force himself away, aggressive moving forward over the Remnant. Looking for the Searing Chains, we'll find it onto Veer. The Weave Armor is now beginning to stack up for the side of EG, so it's not really the best time for CDAC to fight, and they're happy with that. They get themselves another tier 2, and they're just back themselves off here as well.
If they keep farming now, everything is fine for them. I think the ball's in EG's court now to start making a move. If they keep just letting CDC take down the towers, well, there's only one remaining, so I guess they can't lose that much more any longer. I just feel like the cores of CDC are getting a really good game here, even though Samael has so much farm. I don't know if Fear can have the impact he's looking for just yet. It's not like he's poor, but he's falling behind the cores of CDC.
He certainly is. 13,000, 12,000 on the respective Ember and TA. They're now about 2,000 or so behind those. Still got a way to catch up. Aggressive Massive on 2.4k with his Battle Fury. So we'll see if he's able to go for that crit next as its next option.
In addition to that, if you look at the supporting cast, the supports of the Dire are also richer. Marginal lead for the Visage over the Naga, but then a 2,500 difference between the position 5s on the team. And it makes a really big difference. We generally focus a lot on the gold differential between the carries, but having that extra Glimmer Cape and that extra tankiness on your support. How many times have we seen Glimmer Cape win a game in this tournament? Like, I've lost count. I've also never really counted, so it makes it a little bit harder, but...
They're gonna find CC all on his own and put the snowball here, but Fierce doing the damage. Oh, he blinks out. Oh, very nicely done there from Etsy. Can he get himself out of the shards as well? He's playing it perfectly, but Universe is there with a blink of Morrow Strike. They'll find the kill nonetheless. But very nicely done there from XZ, trying to buy as much time as possible, keeping EG occupied. But they will find the kill and they'll find the tier 2 there themselves as well. So EG is going to regain a bit of momentum. But the push is coming here on the bottom lane. Shiki with the Dessa, the familiars as well. Once he gets himself onto a tower, he's pretty darn quickly. Samael with the helm on the butterfly. 1k gold as well. Still looking to be the strongest member of the side of EG at the moment. 17,000 gold on this man. Fear's still got a bit of catching up to do, but it's the good thing, of course, with Fear on the Razor is the fact that if they do take a fight with the Axe, they will be able to push very, very nicely with the Razor.
We're going to see the MKB pickup for Shiki. So what I was going to get at was, if he wants to counter out the Shadow Fiend specifically, MKB is definitely the choice. But for the purpose of fighting pretty much everyone else, there's a lot of value in having the BKB against Sand King, but it can also backfire against Song of the Siren. You can get isolated during BKB and just be brought down very easily from the EG right click. So I actually think in this case, Shiki is definitely making the right choice. Usually we would see BKB, but it's just not that good against EG's heroes. All in all, Dazzle doesn't really care about it. Razor, you can still static link his ultimate.
Making a beeline straight for the top lane. Oh, got it. The Morrow Strike going straight to the top of the Glimmer Cave. He's going to be able to get himself away. Huge for the TP out, but he's there to cancel it. The Dazzle is the mid lane. He's going to be able to find next to the Dazzle. Oh, the Chronic Fist! The Battle Fury damage is not quite enough. Aggressive will go down. And now EG looking for more. Shiki on the back. But are they able to stay? Out comes your song. Now, what's the plan for EG? Who are they going to look to take down first? They're looking for the familiars. They'll find one of them. Will they be able to clean this one up? Here we go. Epicenter from Universe on the sidelines trying to come in, but they're already dead on the side of CDC. The round three is a double kill for Samael. And now they're going to find more. XZ, he's got the snowball, but there's four members of EG here. He's going to go for BD, gets the blink off. Very nicely, and he's going to get himself out. Nicely done from XZ, but nonetheless, CDC losing three. Only finding Universe there. So a very nice fight there for the side of Evil Geniuses. And off the back of that, they may just be able to find a tier 2 here in the mid lane as well.
Yeah, most likely going to be grabbing this now. Interesting to see the Tusk going for the BKB, because if he does and TA doesn't, he's just going to be the one isolated out. And there's a little bit of a disconnect here, so I'm not sure what the goal of BKB is, if he's specifically scared of that Burrow Strike, or if he wants to just be able to do something during the song. Of course, he's more difficult to isolate with the BKB, as he still can use the snowball defensively, but what's... I'm not really sold on this choice. I guess we'll see what XC's plan is.
Ooh, they want to try and catch someone out of fear. Ooh, won't be just quite trapped by the ice shards. We'll be able to get himself around those. CDC just unable to find anyone at the back of that. And EG did find themselves that tier one. So Mel continuing to raise ahead of the game as he's reaching 20,000 in terms of net worth. And sitting on 2.8k, I mean, what is next here for the Shadow Fiend?
Satanic, I think. He might just go straight for it so he can just man fight.
Roshan has fallen to the dark.
When you're this far ahead in terms of farm on a Shadow Fiend, you... Yeah, there we go. Alright.
33 minutes in. This is, I mean, Samael, he's outdoing himself here today. This is a great performance. 6 kills, 6 assists. He's only died once so far this game. He's really putting in the hard work here for EG.
He needs a damage item next, because I don't think he can put enough pressure on them as it is right now. He's going to need a Daedalus or an MKB to, depending on whether there's a butterfly coming up for the TA. I don't think that's going to be Sheikah's next item, so I'm guessing a Daedalus will be the choice of Samael.
He's managed to find a Shiva's Guard here as well now. That's all completed and done as well, and he is catching back up to the TA.
That is a really huge item this game, by the way. The Shiva's Guard is very, very good against TA. The attack speed slow, the move speed slow with the active, and of course making Fear himself very tanky. Lots of armor. We're probably going to see the classic Fear build, which is Shiva's into AC, as the vast majority of the dire damage pretty much exclusively is physical.
They want to find Samael here, and it'll be a massive kill if they can. They're trying to move forward here. Sheikah with the blink, but Samael just 2 down tanky. Oh, where's the tank here? We need to get the universe in and get yourself in it. So there we go with the epic down in the bottom. They turn it around. They get the kill onto Samael. Beautiful play there by Exit with the snub, but they might find more. Chasing down Aoi. The shallow graves there from BBD's. Look at the TP. Can they cancel it? No, they can't. Aoi will get out. They might be able to find PvP here. The ice charge won't be catching, but Sheikah with the slow. Look, it's also 50 down to the snowball as well. Fear gets the talent in comms. Sheikah in a bit of trouble. Needs to get himself up and stun the Aegis. He's AOK. They might even be able to find Fear here as well. A team is going to come straight back into the game. Sheikah's going to look at it with the slow for the trap. The stun is for the familiars. And snow will be thrown out to Sheikah, but EG, they've got 3 here. And Shadow Primitive coming in. Bringing it on Fear. They're going to continue to do it. CDEC! They find Fear as well. None of the heroes on EG have buyback available. And what a fight for CDEC. Look at it all down to XZ. Getting that snowball off just after the song. Beautiful play from the Tusk to avoid the huge team fight that EG tried to jump into CDEC with.
This is...
That's massive. That one play. And they're getting wrapped on the back of it.
This is probably maybe the most gaming, like the biggest impact play we've seen from Tusk all tournament, I think. That could have been such a disaster by Genus, and they just flat out almost win the game. With one
two melee racks. And EG, they're going to feel a bit battered after that one. 13-15. But it doesn't matter about the kills when you're 2 racks down. EG now, what is the plan for them here? How do they recover from that kind of pickup?
I feel like the big issue in this situation is not that... how to explain it? So it's not just that CDEC dodge spells.
Yeah.
It's that the cooldown of the spells they dodge is more than... It's too long. Like, they get too big of an advantage out of it. And, you know, it's one of those situations with that play where it's almost impossible. But what EG, what they need to realize in the moment when they go for that, they're like, oh, there are 5 heroes left, let's go for the Red Crim Sand King combo. What they actually need to do is they need to walk everyone else than Sand King away.
Yeah.
So there's no snowball target. But they need to play off of that. But thinking about that in the moment is so ridiculously hard.
Yeah, especially just how grouped up CDEC, it's just so tasty, EG looking for it, and they're like, this is going to be perfect, but...
Because if they get their full combo there, if there's no snowball, they would be the ones pushing for racks. And or getting a... I guess there was no Roche right then, because they did have the Aegis, but...
Looks like EG, they're going to group up here and start pushing down the mid. But CDC, they want to fight into this. They realize that they're in the strong position now, and they're going to go straight for Tim. Comes onto Samael. He's moving in now with the ice shards. They're going to jump in onto this one. Universe force diving himself out of this. Fear to get the Stallion off to aggressive, and he's going to steal a nice bit of damage here with the song setting it up. So now looking straight up with the aggressive arm of aggression with the Revenant straight out. Now the turn that will find you on the Visage. Backing up now to the side of EG, making that a little bit harder for CDEC to fight into with the slider fizz. Aggressive's going to back off, Sheikah's going to blink away. They're trying to push up to the high ground here, EG. Can they do anything? Can they take the tier 3 main of the racks? XC blinking himself away, tier with dagging himself, going to where they're going for the tier 3. Engagement will come out from the side of CDEC.
Oh yeah, but that Daedalus from Aggressive just easily clears out everything here.
Can't quite get it.
EG have a new Wii. They want to try again. This is a very important ability for them to be able to siege high ground, but they take their minor win. They back off. As in, a lost fight there is probably game. So the risk-reward ratio just not favoring them enough to go for this play.
This is very, very nice from CDC so far. And I mean, looking at the graph as well, it's been up and down, but now favoring the side of CDC. It's still not a huge lead out. They might find DVD though. All on his own. Tusk. Let's catch this, and PPD's going to get away. Okay, very nice done. Only the two of them there at the time. No one else to stop the TP, so PPD gets himself out. But they will find the rest of the Ancients there. Shiki cleaning that. Now with the BKB, MKB, and 2,500 gold. This Shiki's TA is catching up to Samel's SF. He's still 4,000 ahead, but it's the fact that the rest of EG are falling behind in terms of farm that's the real issue against CDC's pulls.
And the more BKBs they're getting, the harder it is for EG to pull off their combo. Because even if they set it up perfectly with the song, if there is no snowball play, at least the TA and Tusk can just both BKB. And then maybe the snowball can save the rest of the team afterwards when he gets BKB off. So, tricky position to be in for EG. It's still a pretty close game. Like, 5,000 golden experience is not that much, but the two melee wrecks are definitely going to hurt EG's economy if this just slows down a little bit. And CDC, once again, I don't think they mind. Aggressive is starting to get a lot of momentum in the game. Has a very high impact in these fights.
And doing a heck of a lot of damage here with that Battle Fury Daedalus combo. With the Mantra as well. Harder and harder for EG to try and lock down in these fights. We've seen him dodge a lot as well with those remnants. And EG looks like they're trying to build up a bit of a momentum, a bit of force down this mid lane as they group up as five. EG and Fierce moving into the jungle. CDC looking ready to back though to try and hold this from their base. They know that EG is coming from. They don't want to be caught out outside of the base. They know that they have the stronger high ground defense here. And just the familiars being sent out here to scout it all out. Looking for them to follow them. Aggressive with the Syrian change to Sumaya. Again, CDC. They definitely look to be waiting for EG to come to them rather than vice versa at this point.
As long as Samael doesn't get focused down super hard in the fight, he should be able to get his Satanic off. So I think the strategy here from CDEC is to not go for Samael, but just try to catch the backline as much as possible. Maybe if they can kill off the Razor, that would be really good so his ultimate doesn't tear down all their armor during the fight. It is... it's actually tricky. I think... I really don't think these fights are favoring anyone very much right now. They did have that incredible fight in the mid game, but...
moving in, XC with the BKB straight onto Fear. With the song. We'll keep Fear for some time. Aggressives here as well, though. They want to fight CD. Universe gets a punch back very nicely onto all two of them, but now they're trying to turn this one. EG Sumail moving forward here. Going for another look at damage. The MKB can't see the car here, but he's still farming the kill onto Shiki. Fear getting close, aggressive. Remnants himself away. XC with a punch. Takes down Fear. Solus looks onto the male. Sumail gets over on the sliding fist. The crit is too much. It's a double kill for XC. They can be able to fight Sumail as well. They will. Three heroes falling on the side of EG and PPD left to run himself away. They're going to chase this one thing on here, CDC. They should be able to find this out as well. And they will indeed. Four heroes dropping on EG and CDC lose nothing. Buyback from Samael and PPD just to defend this bottom lane. And again, CDC's fight. I mean, when they grouped up like that, the Battle Fury, Slider Fist, Daedalus, Ember is going to come out on top every time.
There was a buyback from the TA, so that could be the play for EG here. They did buyback both the Shadow Peak and the to push out the mid lane. If they find the TA again, they could be in a good position, but pretty much anything else than that is probably going to be a game over with the buyback used from Samael. He's finding very little gold right now with that gold penalty. And the next Roshan as well, we need to consider that one as a possibility for CDEC as well. I don't think EG can let them have this. I think the game is just flat out over if they get an Aegis on the TA or the Ember.
Yeah, it's really slipping away. And the fact on the individual net worth that you're now seeing, of course, Ember Spirit, he's actually overtaken Samael's farm. And this is a Samael SF that for the whole game has pretty much consistently been 4,000 ahead of anyone on the side of CDC. So CDC really coming back into their element here. And as you said, as the game gets later, aggressive on his Ember Spirit, it's just going to get scarier and scarier. And it looks like he's going to go for the Skadi here.
Yeah, he almost has it. He needs another 1,100. He's gonna get that very quickly if they grab a Roshan and just a couple of creep camps. There is a DD in the river. They're just saving it for Roche. They don't know the respawn time, of course, but maybe EG can go for some sort of a play here and disallow them from even getting the Roche.
Still just under a minute. Oh, aggressive actually coming into the pit, goes straight back out. Oh, Universe nearly finding a Burrow Strike. But I remember EG, of course, Owie with that song. Maybe they can still find a huge setup or something that's going to favor them, but CDEC, I'm sure they're not going to let that happen. Just guarding the Roshan pit. As you said, this is the really important part for both teams. It's going to be up now in less than 30 seconds. And it is CDEC running closer as EG had to back up just to push those lanes back out.
Yeah, they were hoping to intercept a Roshan attempt there with Song of the Siren and maybe steal it or take a fight. And they get neither. This pretty much free.
And it's up now, CDEC, they're going to go straight to work. And with the damage that they've got as well, I don't know if EG can get her in time. Look how quickly it melts. There's nothing that EG could do. CDEC's physical damage output is ridiculous and aggressive, getting himself the Aegis and taking Roshan down in a matter of seconds.
He can get a Scotty now if he sells his drum, but I think he might want to keep it. Well, he... Okay, looks like he is going to sell that. There we go. So, full Scotty for him, coming out soon when the courier starts moving. Wanted to get the Venom. I see Yasha picked up now for Shiki as well. Oh, actually, he sent it back on the courier. He wanted the cheese instead of the Yasha. So he's not so mobile in the fights right now on the TA. His move speed very limited. He has, of course, got the Blink Dagger, but if that one gets disabled, he could struggle to find a key target to attack.
There we go, CDC. They're ready to try and take this final tier 2 on the side of EG. And EG, it's going to be a hard one to defend. Maybe they'll try and fight into this with the song, but be fighting into Aegis and Cheese. Somehow just on the front. Also moving forward. Universe has getting the shot for aggressive. Sumail trying to trade it for the Searing Change now. Thrown out on the Solar Subsidy. Sumail getting forced back. The Familiars as well, trying to hold EG.
He could kill the birds here. And they're going to be on cooldown for a whole minute. This is a disengaged territory. DC maybe.
No, Remnant away. He'll be fine. Actually moving back in. Just with the slight of fist, with the weave. And stacking up here onto Sumail. He's got a hell of a lot of armor. Over 50 at the moment, so not the time to fight into. They'll wait until that's come off, and then CDC may just be confident in hanging around for more. I feel they're in a very safe position to do so. With the Aegis and the cheese available. And onto the tier 2 they go. Let's see what EG can do to stop this. Oh, looks a bit Sumail. Just spinning hits and, well, aggressive. Hit him with a slight. They'll have the set of here of yours. But he's got a round. And the Burrow Strike from Universe. Ember just proving very hard to control at this point in the game. And there's a lot of CDC moving in. Smail's got to be careful how far he comes up the lane. Spring James will catch him on top as well. And now, okay, just get a nice static link off here. Tombstone's going to be dropped now with the song. They'll be able to remove the Tombstone. Let's see if they can find the back to Sumail. We'll find it here. Guarding low. Just getting in 10 out of this fight. Here, so much. We'll be able to find Guarding. Yes, they'll find the Undying here. They'll look toward XC on the top. It's almost up to your prime back towards Aoi. Sumail couldn't look. Got the shallow grave here. Shiki look for BBT. Trying to force that down, but we'll find it. Shiki eats the cheese. But he's going to go down and do it well, potentially. Yes, he will. Shiki's going to fall. Now, Sumail, he's getting low. He's going to fall out. It's a 3-for-3, and now they'll be able to find James Wilson. It's a 3-for-1. It's aggressive, has no damage, he's got enough. Triple kill. Are we looking for the TP? Can they cancel it? Yes! The Searing Chase is going to be a 3-wipe for CDPGG! They've outplayed EG! What a performance from CDEC! Coming back from what looked like the most horrific early game. Just dominating EG that one fight in the middle against the two sets of racks, and then after that, aggressive Ember Spirit getting out of control, and EG just didn't have an answer.
And that last team fight, that was probably the best EG could have hoped for. They get a full static link off and aggressive, yep. So he loses a lot of damage. They destroy the Tombstone, they get a really good Requiem, but the Aegis and Cheese, CDEC just with